Chapter 190, Samsara Martial Intent. Na Shui immediately paled as she listened to these men sexually harass her. However, Na Yi was calm as she cheekily sneered. These fellows are such idiots, they really are courting death. Lin Ming's fingers traced the treasure saber that was on the table. This was the medium-grade human step treasure saber that Huo Gong had left behind after his untimely demise. Lin Ming had decided to use it as a temporary weapon in order to deceive the world. When he would assassinate Kaiga, he would do so with a spear. Lin Ming didn't want anyone to find clues tracing back to him because of the weapon he used. Lin Ming sent a true essence sound transmission to Na Yi. I had just wanted to listen in on them to get some information on Kaiga, but it seems that's not going to be happening anymore. How would you like me to punish them? Na Yi's icy gaze swept across the five soldiers with a heartless killing intent. She frostily said, if possible, I hope that Mr. Mo can kill all of them. Lin Ming was shocked. Good heavens, this little girl was sufficiently ruthless. But today, if he didn't do anything, then these soldiers would most likely go on to rape other girls in the future. The Fireworm tribe was a wholly barbaric group of people that even ate humans. Rape wasn't considered much to them. If they would ever rape young girls in the future, then killing them all now would only be a form of mercy. If we fight here, then we'll have to leave Fog Valley afterwards. Lin Ming said, I do not have to stay here. A change of scenery is just fine. These Fireworm tribe soldiers are all criminals that know only how to commit atrocious deeds. If they can be promoted to a position in the army where they can lead others, then they'd have done things that are deserving of death. The method in which the Fireworm tribe raised their soldiers was heinous and cruel. The way they trained their soldiers were no different than training a pack of vicious beasts. All of this was done in order to keep their most basic animal instincts intact, so that they would be invincible and all-conquering, being able to grasp victory in any situation. Na Yi felt only bone-deep hatred for the entire Fireworm tribe. 1 year ago, they had conducted a complete genocide of her Na tribe, burnt and looted her town, raped and pillaged. There was simply no end to their evil deeds. A large number of the Na tribe commoners had been turned into slaves, and there were even those that were eaten alive. That's why today, as Na Yi faced these five Fireworm soldiers, she wished that they would all suffer cruel and miserable deaths. Lin Ming saw Na Yi's resentment-filled glare and said, I understand. This is fine. I just happened to want to ask them about Kaiguda's whereabouts. The five Fireworm soldiers saw Lin Ming touch his saber and revealed a gloating smile. Boss, this boy is interesting. He actually dares to touch his saber in front of us. This playboy is so damn stupid. Can he not see our cultivation? The man with a spear on his back said, these playboys are used to being domineering and lawless within their own little tribes. There isn't anything strange about this. Since the girls wear masks, telling from their attire they might be from the Orchid Nun tribe. Hehe, how amusing. An aristocrat from such a small tribe actually dares to be so rampant within our land. Let's play around with this boy and beat him up until all his teeth are gone. We'll call those two little girls over and see if they are then willing to give themselves up to rescue their young master. Haha. Boss, this is a great idea. With their young master in our hands, those two girls will not dare to resist us. Haha. Several soldiers laughed as they stood up. They didn't take out their weapons, and simply walked towards Lin Ming unarmed. The innkeeper saw this and went ghastly white. He wasn't worried about the safety of Lin Ming's group, but rather feared that his tables and chairs would be smashed apart. He only hoped that these three wouldn't try to resist, lest his inn be ruined. At the moment, there weren't many visitors eating meals within. They had seen that something was wrong, and immediately got up and scurried out, so as not to be affected by any potential fallout, or caught in a possible spell of bad luck. Even the waiter had run away, leaving the innkeeper all by himself. The innkeeper had ran to the second floor for fear of being accidentally killed by some stray blow. Little boy, this is the wrong place and time for you to be an aristocratic junior. You actually came to our territory and acted so arrogantly, you are so damn stupid. If you know what to do, then kneel on the ground, bow down three times, and give us those two girls for us to enjoy this evening. If you do so, then we'll let you keep your dog life. As the bearskin soldier said that, he reached out to grab Lin Ming's arm. In his opinion, this playboy young master had only just started practicing martial arts. It would be child's play to remove his arm. But as he touched Lin Ming, Lin Ming's aura suddenly changed. His restrained breath and vague true essence fluctuations instantly billowed into the sky, directly piercing the horizon. A surge of dragon yangqi erupted from Lin Ming's body. The bearskin soldier instantly heard a horrifying sound within his ears. It was the roar of dragons and tigers. Even though he had fought in many battles and had a firm will and resolute mind, after hearing this dragon's roar, his entire body started trembling, as his heart began to swell with a fear that came from the very depths of his soul. Bonk, quickly dodge. The eyes of the spear-wielding soldier flashed and he instantly felt as if something was wrong. He flourished his spear and rushed towards Lin Ming, but at this moment, he suddenly slowed his steps. He saw that Lin Ming had gripped the bearskin soldier's neck. That Zhong, who was usually fearless in battle, seemed to have turned dumb and let the young boy grab him. The spear-wielding soldier frowned, and he stopped. He suddenly realized that they had really stepped in SHT today. What was going on? How come a master like this suddenly appeared in Fog Valley? Not only that, but they had probed this boy's cultivation just a moment ago, and they had clearly seen he was new to martial arts. Now his cultivation had experienced a dramatic rise to the peak of bone forging. Although he wore a bamboo hat, the soldier was able to roughly estimate that he was no more than 20 years old. This kind of age with this kind of cultivation was very unusual. Also, he was skilled in some sort of mystical witchcraft technique, otherwise there would be no way for Hong to instantly lose all bodily response and so easily fall into the enemy's hands. Dealing with an enemy like this who was so skilled in these subversive skills was the most difficult. The spear-wielding soldier's face sank as he said, Friend, let go of my brother, and we shall consider this matter today as settled. Although I don't know how you concealed your cultivation or what sort of secret skills you have, right now your cultivation is about the same as me. We have five people, and you are only one, and you also have two little girls following you. It wouldn't be good if they were to be accidentally injured. Lin Ming remained unmoved. He still gripped the bearskin soldier's neck like before. The bearskin soldier had tried to respond, but it was as if he was a little mouse that had been bitten by a predatory serpent. Lin Ming's hand was already pressed against his life gate, and true essence had penetrated his body. With a single thought from Lin Ming, he would simply drop dead. The bearskin soldier's forehead was already seeping with sweat. He couldn't even slowly move his fingers toward the saber that he had behind him. The spear-wielding soldier saw that his threats didn't work, and coldly said, "Let him go at once. Do not think that I am afraid of you. I've also seen witchcraft similar to this. Not only does this witchcraft consume an enormous amount of soul force, but it also cannot be used on many people at once." Before the spear-wielding soldier finished speaking, he saw that Lin Ming seemed to be smiling, and then he heard a cracking sound. Bong's head was bent at a weird angle, as his body slid to the ground like jelly. Bong. The spear-wielding man's eyes turned red with fury. "You fucking core death, kill him, all together." The spear-wielding man roared. The three other soldiers behind him saw that their brother had died, and blood instantly rushed to their heads. Together, they rushed at Lin Ming. "You can all die." Lin Ming revolved all of the true essence within his body, and with a single step, he suddenly burst into golden rock, shattering the void. To him, distance had lost all meaning. He appeared like a ghost behind the sword-wielding soldier, a punch rocketing towards his side. The soldier had experienced countless life and death situations on the battlefield. His reaction speed was much quicker than that of a martial artist who only cultivated martial arts. His response wasn't decided by the brain. It was the reflexive instinct of the body. He slashed out his sword towards Lin Ming's fist. His eyes filled with a manic look. He wanted to cut open Lin Ming's sword hand. But at this moment, an unimaginable scene took place. Lin Ming's closed fist became an open claw that grabbed the sword. With a tug, the soldier was viciously pulled over. Lin Ming raised his knee and slammed it against the soldier's abdomen. Bang! The power of flow like silk erupted, and vibrating true essence filaments instantly broke into the soldier's organs. They vibrated within his body so intensely that even his leather armor began to crack. The soldier didn't even have time to cough. Blood exploded from all the orifices of his head and he instantly died on the spot. Third. The spear-wielding soldier's eyes had turned blood red. His whole body began to emit a murderous aura that soared to the heavens. He had already gone insane. He swept out his arm, wanting Lin Ming to be cut in half by his spear. However, Lin Ming actually grabbed onto where the spear shaft and spearhead met. In that moment, the spear he was holding seemed to be an unyielding statue, and he wasn't able to move it one bit. Die. Another sword-wielding soldier seized this opportunity to swing his sword towards Lin Ming's neck. However, Lin Ming reacted as if he had eyes on the back of his head. He turned around and easily grabbed that sword, then pushed it downwards. Lin Ming pulled on the long spear, and that long spear thrust towards the sword-wielding man's chest. The spear pierced him and then pulled back out. The sword-wielding soldier began to violently tremble. Puff. A torrent of blood blasted out several feet, conveniently splashing onto the face of the spear-wielding soldier. The spear-wielding soldier looked at his hands, eyes glazed over and completely lifeless. The spear that was used to pierce the heart of his brother was actually in his grasp. He had never even dreamed that this would ever happen, where he would be completely unable to resist such an oppressive force. It had crushed his heart's arrogance, cruelty, and the faith he had in himself. At this moment, the final soldier rushed towards Na Yi and Na Shui, a grimly determined expression on his face. He knew that the only way he would have even a slim chance of survival was by capturing these two women. However, just as that grim determination had appeared, it was forever frozen as it was. The world around him instantly fell away as everything became dark. All he could see was a massive black tornado in front of him. He was unable to resist the stifling power of this vortex and was gradually sucked towards it. Then, the scenery changed again. He had inexplicably returned to when he was young. However, this experience of his youth was completely different to what he remembered. It was an absolutely bizarre feeling, as if he was seeing his own past lives. One after another, endless scenes began to rapidly revolve through his mind, converging, dividing. He saw countless phantoms of himself. He saw himself freshly dressed and happy upon a horse. He saw himself huddled on a street corner. He saw his life as he made rapid achievements, and he also saw himself begging for mercy for his own life. After experiencing countless samsaras, he still hadn't found one that was the true him. The intricate webs of confusing memories were like a profound tide that plunged into his spiritual sea. The severe pain caused him to wish for death. Ah! The sword-wielding soldier emitted a horrifying scream, filled with despair. His spiritual sea was twisted by that swirling black vortex and completely shattered into shards, leaving only echoing fragments within the broken remnants of his spiritual sea. Just who am I? Who? Apostrophe.